everybody. I am Pat Howell. I am from Greensboro, North Carolina. I'm a sophomore at Elon University, and I am a marketing and business management double major.
Lauren, my older sister, she's 3 years older. She went on one of the first few years of the Globally Cape Town trip, and she absolutely loved it, loved the adventure and service learning aspect that Global Lead provides, and she just really strongly recommended the program to me. And when I had an opening for this summer, I decided to just take the chance and go for it.
I did not know anyone coming into the program. I had emailed Courtney probably about 100 times back and forth, so I felt like I knew her relatively well, but I had not met slash previously known anyone else from the program, and within probably 3 days felt that I knew more about some of these people than I did about some of my closest friends at home. There's still a lot more to learn about everyone, so I'm looking forward to it.
Hello world, my name is Pat. I'm about to learn how to salsa, and it's looking good so far. We're gonna see how it works out, but right now the ratio is definitely in my favor.
The salsa dancing, I'm not a very skilled dancer in any way. I'm a very goofy kid, and I don't really hide it. And salsa dancing is an absolute blast, getting to go out and just kind of let loose with the whole group. The city's so massive that there would be no way that we could even cover 10% of it in the entire month here. There's always somewhere new to go. The food is amazing. I don't think there's as much good food in all of North Carolina as within a 5-block radius of our hotel. You can literally find anything you want. If you want meat on a stick, you've got it. If you want Italian food, you've got it. If you want Mexican food, you've got it. The Ecuadorian food we've had has been amazing so far. It's different. I've tried so many new things and loved almost every one of them. But don't try to get hamburgers. They're not quite as good. We climbed up the basilica, which was absolutely amazing. One of the best views of the city in Old Town. When I was a kid, I was afraid of heights, and I conquered that fear of heights when I started rock climbing, and I was very much so reintroduced to that fear of heights, climbing up the ladders in the basilica.
We were up there.
It absolutely blew my mind. There were a few parts where I was amazed they even let people climb. I'm excited for service. I think that's going to give us a much more well-rounded view of the culture, as opposed to just going in and meeting people at restaurants and at salsa lessons, going in and really meeting people who live their everyday lives here.
We got a few child prodigies here. There are a few kids that have got skills way beyond their level.
When you get here, these kids just shower you with love. No matter how much you think that you're gonna have an impact on them, they double that impact back on you.
I feel like it's the end of chapter one as opposed to the end of the book. I feel an amazingly strong bond to this country already, and whether it's the same kids here at the school or a different group of kids, it's been a very unique experience so far for my life. And it's really changed the way that I view travel and what it means to really go to another country.
With mountain biking in Cotopaxi, that was such a blast.
My dad today has been awesome. We had a slight delay getting our bikes. Unfortunate flat tire for the bike truck. But got some awesome lunch, awesome chocolate cake. Now I'm burning it off. Got the whole group pretty much together and having a blast.
I still am raving about the food. We just keep going back to a few of the same places, meat on a stick lady. It's tough because everywhere is so delicious and they have so much good food. I don't want to go back to the U.S. at all. Like I have 5 bottles of hot sauce in my bag already that I've accumulated because I plan on cooking with a whole lot more flavor when I get back. I had a very different picture of the jungle.
Welcome to the jungle.
Yeah.
Welcome to the jungle. We got fun and games. We got everything you want.
And the jungle. Trees, big trees. I'm excited to get back to Quito to my meat on a stick lady. I kind of have like dreams about her. She's amazing and she makes the best meat on a stick I've ever had in the world. So that was an absolutely amazing hike. Going up, essentially hiking around Crater Lake and seeing like the islands down below. It was not an easy hike by all means, but it was awesome having the whole group there.
Let it be known that multiple rotator cuffs have been torn, arms have been broken, and of course, pride has been smashed due to this simple little competition. Today we find ourselves on the edge of Lake Bicocha.
We're going fishing.
Oh!
Fine.
Oh, that one was a flyer! That one was a flyer! Oh, and it hits! I saw it hit in the water! Oh. It goes in! It might be on film!
When I started looking for summer abroad programs, I wanted more of an outdoorsy backpacking trip. And this trip has ended up being perfect for me. It's just enough outdoors. We get to explore as much as we want to. Whereas there are some people on this trip that I feel more wanted to stay in hotels everywhere they go. And they are just as happy as I am. It's such a versatile trip and you can do so much in this country. It's amazing.
Well, it's been good having you on camera. Appreciate your patience and willingness, openness, transparency, all that. Any parting thoughts, closing words of wisdom from you? Be Pat Howell.
I think you have to be willing to get out of your comfort zone. You can't come to Ecuador and want to sit on a couch and watch TV all day. You're going to have to get out. You're going to have to hike. You're going to have to push your body. You know, you have to be willing to push yourself.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, Pat Howell wrapped up 4 weeks ago. Peace out. Cut.